We've seen the damage along the coastline of Central Florida during hurricane season, surging water and waves from powerful storms that leave coastal areas battered.
And now experts say sea level rise predicted for the next 30 years is threatening more than the coastline, and not just in hurricane season. First Warning meteorologist Alex Alesi explains the risk rising with the tide.
Surrounded by ocean and speckled with lakes, rivers, and abundant waterways, Florida has a special interest in how the tides, or more specifically, water levels, rise and fall. But now they are mostly rising, and data from the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration shows the sea level rise pattern isn't stopping.
Basically, the momentum is already built into the system. The models are all suggesting a certain amount of rise at 2050. When we overlay the observations and the trajectory that they're on at a global, national, and regional level, the two are squarely in line, giving us more confidence to say with clarity what to expect in terms of sea level rise by 2050.
Dr. Sweet tells me we can expect about a foot of sea level rise over the next 30 years. That's a foot more of water in 30 years when it had previously taken 100 years to get to that level. Here's what NOAA says that means for life in Florida.
The net effect is we're going to have deeper, more severe tidal flooding. But the nuisance flooding that's occurring now is going to become sort of incessant. It's going to become sort of a new normal. So a flood regime shift, moderate damaging flooding is going to occur at a more frequent basis. The more disruptive flooding is going to become sort of the new normal.
And when you add a hurricane into the mix, the impacts are even more devastating.
Well, there's sort of a trifecta, if you will, of things going on. One is sea levels rising, but the things that are causing sea levels to rise to begin with, in additional heat in the ocean and the atmosphere, causing the ice to melt and the thermal expansion, it's also fueling stronger storms. So that's to be expected in a warming climate. It's also able to hold more moisture, heavier precipitation. And so when you put the three together, potentially stronger storms, creating larger storm surge on top of higher sea levels with more rain, that doesn't bode well for coastal communities in harm's way.
It's not just the coast that needs to take notice, it's inland areas too.
The infrastructure is laid. Houses, roads, storm, wastewater systems, hospitals, schools. Things are on the ground and they're there. And so as Freeboard, or the gap between, you know, our infrastructure and the high tides starts to close, there's only so much we can tolerate. And so I think we have to keep that in perspective, not only what to expect at 2050, but beyond.
That's exactly what Sustainability and Resilience Manager Katrina Locke does with Volusia County's Environmental Management, keeping sea level rise in perspective when planning for new projects and system upgrades.
We've really promoted low impact development and green infrastructure as some of the practices that can be used to alleviate or mitigate the impacts of flooding.
Low impact development looks for ways to build that will work with the environment. How can stormwater be absorbed rather than create runoff? Locke says another important step everyone can take is reducing emissions.
So, you know, any of these things that you do to reduce your energy use are going to have a really positive impact on your costs too. So there's, you know, not just from our operations perspective, but also from, you know, the individual's perspective.
If everyone gets on board and makes small changes now, the hope is we can minimize those impacts in the future.